Hello, happy site owners and webmasters. Man, here with a BlogAid Today tip about the new Chrome 62 version not showing the non-secure HTTPS or non-secure warning on non-HTTPS sites, and here's why. And thank you so very much to Rolando Garcia. Thank you for cluing me in what was going on. So here's the deal. That feature is only turned on by default for about 10% of the people that Chrome 62 is rolled out to. And it has Chrome 62 is not updated for everybody yet. You know, I had to manually update to it. So it'll be a few days and maybe a few weeks before it automatically wants to update or whatever for everybody. And that feature still may not be turned on. So we may have bought some time here with these HTTPS conversions. So if you haven't gotten your HTTPS conversion done yet, yeah, okay, you might still have some time, maybe a week or something before this rolls out. But for everybody who wants to test it, I tried to test it. I don't think they've worked the kinks out of this thing yet. So it's still kind of maybe in beta or something, I don't know. So maybe not every feature is full blast on, but it's there. So I'm going to show you how to test it. Thank you to Rolando for this tip on that. So now you can look in the description above or below this video, wherever you're watching it, and you're going to see the little code that I'm going to put in. So I've got the Chrome browser. Now you'll see why I'm so little down here. I was like, hey, I'm down here, you know, because I need to show you some things on the screen. You can't really see my URL bar very well, what I put in there. But open up Chrome and go get this little piece of code or this URL from the description of this video. And it's chrome:\flags/\mark-non-secure-as. Okay, now you could just put in the Chrome flags part of it, and it'll take you to all the flags that are available, because you can customize the way Chrome works, but these flags and stuff, they're not supported all the way across the browser evenly for everybody. So if you put this one in, it's going to take you directly to that one in the list. And let me tell you something, you're going to want that because it's a huge list, all right? So I'm going to blow this up like crazy, I hope. Maybe. Oh, gosh, did I lose it? Oh, no. We're going to re-enable that. There it is. So we can find it again. So hopefully you can see this a little bit better. So here we are on the Mark non-secure origins as non-secure, and this is supposed to be supported on Mac, Windows, Linux, Chrome OS, and Android. Okay, it doesn't say, well, it says Mac. We don't know if that's iPhones and whatever too that might be using the Chrome browser and iPads and things like that. So you have a choice in this drop down. See, and this is what I had set mine to, but if it's set to default, you will never see this new warning, which is what it was set at when I went in there. And then the next one is warn on HTTP after editing forms. So I guess I don't know if it does that as you're typing or what the deal is, or if it tells you, hey, you just entered stuff into a non-secure site. I don't know. It says after. I don't know. Okay. So the next one is warn on HTTP while in incognito mode. Now, we knew this was coming because the whole point of it, what their explanation is, the whole point of incognito is that you're not tracking anything and you have a secure connection kind of thing. So you have some expectation of privacy. That was exactly what they said about it. So if you just go to incognito window, if you open one of those and go to an HTTP site, you should see the warning. You don't even have to fill in a form. You should just see the warning. Okay, now this one says warn on HTTP while in incognito mode or after editing form. So it kind of combines these two. And then this one is always mark HTTP as actively dangerous. You know, I kind of want to see that. I want to see what that looks like. I don't know what level of this will be rolled out by default when they do fully support it in Chrome 62, but that one sounds like, whoa, okay, so let's go try this and see how it works. So I'm going to go to, I'm going to try to put two things together here, the incognito mode or after editing form. So we should be able to go to incognito and do it. Now, when you click something on here there should be a button somewhere, and maybe it's just blown up too much for us to see, to relaunch Chrome. Let's see. I don't even see it. And oh, that's because I had that one selected before. So let me select something else. Just incognito mode. Okay, when you make a change, you should see this button for relaunch now. Okay, so I'm going to relaunch now, and it's going to go back the same one. I'm going to put it back where I had it, incognito mode or after editing forms. And I'm going to relaunch now. Now, I had already cleaned out my cache in here, but, you know, just because I'm going to clean it out again. So go up to your three little dots, more tools, and then it's got clear browsing data. So we're going to do that, and it says, yeah, let's get everybody out of there, okay? So we're all out, and it's fine, and it returns you to your settings page. Okay, now I should be completely cleaned out of any kind of anything that I had in there, right? And so I'm going to go to the three little dots and do new incognito window. Now this alone, if I go to an HTTP site, this alone should flag it. All right, so I'm going to go to blogownpurpose.com, which is one of the domains that I own, and I'm currently using it to test our comment reply plugins, which we're actually through with. So that particular testing site is in every kind of state, different kind of state all the time, depending on what I'm testing, right? So the minute I go to this site, I should see the warning with that flag turned on. So I'm jumping over to that site, and all it says up here is the regular not secure. Where's the warning? I mean, that's it? Not secure? That's it? That's all there is? Really? Okay, so I copied my form from BlogAid over here for my opt-in, and I've already tried this. I'm just going to go tell you. I entered an email address. Nothing happened. It worked just fine. There was no extra warning, no anything. So I'm wondering if they've worked out the kinks on this yet, you know, because that's it? Not secure? Okay, so let's go to this in a non-incognito window, just, you know, a regular window, because it came up a little different for me in there. I don't know if I can reproduce it, but we'll see. No, I saw for a moment, just in a regular window, I saw not secure in red. It was in red text. But that was it. It was up here by the bar. So instead of this little eye in a circle that you have to click to view the site information that tells you your connection's not secure, it had red letters up there that said not secure. But I haven't been able to reproduce it. So, yeah, I just kind of wanted you to know what was going on with this thing. I mean, so maybe I'm missing something. Now, I am streaming live on this, so I want to jump over, refresh my little page here on my iPad because I can never see it on desktop. And I'm going to go over here and see who's watching, who's listening, who's putting comments in. And, you know, I came online earlier today, I live streamed earlier today, and the stars were not aligned right. I did it over on my personal page. I even advertised that it was going to be, I put the wrong time on it. So, I didn't advertise this one, and, you know, we're okay. So, yeah, I see a few people watching, no comments, okay, so I'm going to keep going. So there's that one. Now let's go back to these flags because I want to set it to the always mark HTTP as actively dangerous. I haven't tried this one yet. Let's just go see what this will do to us. And you know, I'm going to kill that and kill this. And I'm going to kill my cache one more time. Go to more tools, clear browsing cache just to be sure. I'm not even going to go to incognito. This should work on everything. So I'm going to go to that blog on purpose.com, and it should, whatever the most horrendous thing is it can do, should come up. There it is. There's the red thing. See, it's, I don't know if y'all can see this. It says not secure. And I don't think anything I can do to blow that up so you can't see it. But there it is. There's the huge warning. This is what we were afraid of? Okay, I don't know that that many people, maybe folks are starting to look up in the URL bar, but I only do when I'm putting in some credit card information or something. I rarely, if ever, look just to put in an email address. How about you? So This is the big, scary, not secure warning. Everything I saw said it was going to be some honking thing right here in the middle of the page. And I've seen that on occasion where, you know, it obfuscates the whole page and says, this is not secure. And that's what I thought we were going to get. And I think a lot of other people did too, because I saw screenshots of that saying, this is what we're going to get. So, that's it. Okay, so, and I don't know, guys, maybe it will change, because obviously they're still working this out, and it's not rolled out to everybody yet, and even if it does, that's not as bad as we thought, okay? So, and I don't know, maybe they'll change that later, but I'm just going on what I can see here, and it's like, well, that's not so scary. So, if you have not converted to HTTPS yet, you still have time. You know, this just kind of extended who knows how long, right? But get a full conversion because you do have time. I am still taking requests daily. As a matter of fact, I got a bunch of them today because I rolled out the new service for after HTTPS conversion, and I'm going to go over to BlogAid so you can see the two services for this because you still got time to do this. I'm going to go over to BlogAid.net. It's under Site Services, HTTPS Conversion. Go there. And you can see the two services. One is for full HTTPS conversion. This is not the trickery at the host. You're not relying on the host. As a matter of fact, there's a nice article here for the top 10 reasons not to go the free way. But I know millions of people did. So if you did, I've opened up an after HTTPS service. And what this does is in a live session, we check all the stuff that needs to be updated after you go to HTTPS, and you can see the long list of stuff here that gets checked in that live session, and I have been walloped. It went up on a group board today, and I have been walloped with emails for this service, so make sure that everything is good for you. So, there it is, you know, and now you know how to check things for yourself. And there, I want to get over here to comments. Tammy, I'm seeing you. My secure in the browser is always shown. What? Not secure? So, Tammy, if you've got anything on there that's giving you mixed media issues, then it would show it's not secure. So, you know, guys, if you want to know how to test some of these things, you can go over there. I don't know what Blog on Purpose will show us. Let's see. You can go up to the three little dots and go down to More Tools and Developer Tools, and you can see for yourself what's going on with it. What may be blocked? Oh, this is new. They're giving us a message here. Well, I don't have anything to show you because nothing's being blocked because that site is not HTTPS to begin with. But if you go to some, and I don't want to go to any client site and show off their stuff, but there would be red things all over here for things that are blocked. There would be yellow things for warnings that are causing mixed media. I didn't have my screenshot up. But anyway, it's in Developer Tools. You're in the console section of Developer Tools. Is where it is. So, just to let you know, but mixed media, any kind of mixed media. And what I'm finding is a lot of people are asking about that, said they had their host do the HTTPS switch. I'm not even calling it a conversion because it's not converted, it's a switch. And they've got images being brought in for link parties or from their old blogger site or whatever, and none of those links are updated. And those sites are not HTTPS. And so, you can link out to anything that's HTTP just fine. You can't bring anything in and serve it on your site that's not from an HTTPS source. That's the problem. And so that's the biggest reason that you could have your site converted but still be getting mixed media issues on there that knock out your secure. The other one is running ads. And these ad networks will randomly send through an HTTP ad, and several of them have content security policies that they want you to use to stop that so that you never lose your secure setting. So, you know, those are the kinds of things we can check for. There are a couple of content security policies. One of them kind of fudges things just a little bit and helps you out. And the other one is a block all that just, if it's HTTP, it just gets blocked. It's not going to get shown, which means all that stuff disappears. So, you know, that's what I was telling people about the free way of doing things. You could be getting a little green padlock and it's saying secure just because everything is blocked that's a real problem. You don't have all those underlying issues fixed, or you've got a big band-aid over it, like this content security policy that just blocks everything. You'll never see it, and stuff has just disappeared off your site, and you won't find that out until later. So, you know, that's the way that is. But at least now we know why we didn't get a great big non-secure warning in the first place today, so I'm thrilled to know that. And thank you so much to Rolando for letting me know what that was and how to set that flag. But even when it's set, it's not as bad as we thought. Not yet, anyway. So you still have time. You still have time, guys. So get in there and get your... And there's millions of site owners who have not even heard they need to do this yet. And seeing that, they probably never visit their sites much either, and they're never going to see something like that. You know, I know a lot of folks who don't depend on their site for a lot of traffic. You know, it's just kind of an online brochure thing, and they never visit it. Yeah, they probably have no idea that this is happening. And being able to look at that little red non-secure. So it's not. It's only turned on for about 10% of people. It's probably not set to this most horrendous thing or whatever. And it may be weeks before we actually see this thing roll out, and even then it may not be so bad, or they may put that big honking thing on it that other people have taken screenshots of and said this is what's coming. It's Google, who knows? They run on their own timeline, don't they? All right, guys, that's the BlogAid Today tip, and at least we know one. I'm going to share this over with my webmaster because they were all asking about it too. All right, y'all have a good night. And I'll see you online.